This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Welcome on this third Sunday after Pentecost, this Youth Music Sunday. Just one or two announcements before we begin this morning. Please don't forget that right after worship downstairs, the NAACP will be putting on the Healthy Church Tour. They'll be providing healthy snacks, and they'll be talking about diabetes care. So please stop downstairs for some fellowship and some great discussion. The Spirit is doing so much through First Presbyterian Church. So again, I ask that you please read through your bulletin, your Friday emails, your newsletter, to see all that's happening around here. And as we gather today by the power of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to let go of all of our worries and distractions that keep us from being all that God has created us to be. Instead, let us be filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. Let us prepare our hearts and minds by inviting the Spirit to be here among us this morning as we listen to the prelude performed by the youth of our congregation, who are indeed filled with the music of the Spirit.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry. All who dwell in deepest sin, my hand will save. I who make the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart.
Please join me in our call to worship this morning from Psalm 130. Out of the depths I cry to you, O Lord. One, hear my voice. I wait for the Lord. My soul waits. In God's word, I hope. My soul waits for the Lord more than those who watch for the morning. For with the Lord there is steadfast love and great power to redeem. Our gathering hymn this morning is hymn number 514, Let Us Talents and Tongues Employ.
Thank you. God calls us like a good parent to guide and protect us, to nourish and lead us. Jesus calls us to live lives of loving service, and the Holy Spirit calls us to heal and to move ever closer into fellowship with God and each other. Yet so often we don't take time to hear and respond. Let us confess the ways we have ignored God's calling. God, your Spirit calls to us, yet like unruly children, we strain at your guidance. We try to break away ourselves. We feel our strength and imagine we can do things without you. We know our talents not to be independent, rather depend on you. When we feel weak, we turn to one another. Before we know it, we are in the grips of other powers, leading us away from our loving into slavery, selfish greed, adoring false gods, materialism, and power. Open your eyes to your wisdom and know true leadership you service. Open our hearts to separate. And we are all one. We now take a few moments of silence for private individual confession. Amen. God calls us to free us from possession by all sorts of demons, to a possession by the Holy Spirit. Through Jesus Christ, our hearts are open to live like him, and we are forgiven. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Beloved God, we pray this morning that we may experience that peace that passes all understanding, that we may experience you, the living peace of our world. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Set free by God's grace, let us share God's peace with one another. Be seated. As we prepare to hear God's word spoken and proclaimed, let us pray for illumination. Draw us close, Holy Spirit, as the scriptures are read and the word is proclaimed. Let the word of faith be on our lips and in our hearts, and let all other words slip away. May there be one voice we hear today, the voice of truth and grace. Amen. Life in the present is transitory and cannot compare with the eternal home God has prepared for us. So we do not despair, no matter what life may bring, because we know that as God raised Jesus from the dead, God promises to bring us into eternal life. Our reading today is from 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verses 13 through chapter 5 verse 1. But just as we have the same spirit of faith that is in accordance with Scripture, I believed and so I spoke. We also believe and so we speak, because we know that the one who raised the Lord Jesus will raise us also with Jesus and will bring us with you into his presence. Yes, everything is for your sake, so that grace, as it extends to more and more people, may increase thanksgiving to the glory of God, so we do not lose heart, even though our outer nature is wasting away Our inner nature is being renewed day by day. For this slight momentary affliction is preparing us for an eternal weight of glory beyond all measure, because we look not at what can be seen, but what it cannot be seen. For what can be seen is temporary, but what cannot be seen is eternal. For we know that if the earthly tent we live in is destroyed, we have a building from God, a house not made with hands, eternal in heavens. The word of the Lord. That was quite an age range we had there in our choir. A house divided against itself cannot stand. Jesus makes this observation in light of charges that he is possessed. He is possessed, not by a demon, but by the Holy Spirit. We who have received the Holy Spirit through baptism have been joined to Christ's death and resurrection and knit together in the body of Christ. Those who do the will of God are possessed by the Holy Spirit, siblings of Christ. We read Mark chapter 30, verses 20 through 35. Then he went home, and the crowd came together again so that they could not even eat. When his family heard it, they went out to restrain him, for people were saying, "He has gone out of his mind." And the scribes who came down from Jerusalem said, "He has Beelzebub, and by the ruler of the demons, he cast out demons." And he called to them, and he spoke to them in parables. How can Satan cast out Satan? If a kingdom is divided against itself, that kingdom cannot stand. And if a house is divided against itself, that house will not be able to stand. And if Satan has risen up against himself and is divided, he cannot stand, but his end has come. But no one can enter a strong man's house and plunder his property without first tying up the strong man. Then indeed the house can be plundered. Truly I tell you, people will be forgiven for their sins in whatever blasphemies they utter. But whoever blasphemes against the Holy Spirit can never have forgiveness, but is guilty of an eternal sin. For they had said, he has an unclean spirit. Then his mothers and brothers came, and standing outside, they sent to him and called him. A crowd was sitting around him, and they said to him, "Your mother and your brothers and sisters are outside asking for you." And he replied, "Who are my mother and my brothers?" And looking at those who sat around him, he said, "Here are my mother and my brothers. Whoever does the will of God is my brother and sister and mother." The word of the Lord.
Spirit, we are one in the Lord. We are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord. And we pray that our unity may one day be restored. And other, we will walk hand in hand. We will walk with each other. We will walk hand in hand. And together we'll spread the news that God is in our land. Side by side, we will work with each other. We will work side by side, and we'll guard each man's dignity and save each man's pride.
Amazing talent we have in this congregation from the youth. Please, let's give them another hand. Let us pray. Lord, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight. O God, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. What possessed you to do that? Has anyone ever said that to you, or perhaps have you said that to someone else? Show of hands, anybody? What possessed you to paint the wall that color? Or what possessed you to say that? Or what possessed you to take on such a big project? Most of the time, the word possessed is not used in a positive way. It's often associated with being influenced or controlled or consumed by some negative evil spirit. And if you've ever witnessed a child's outrageous temper tantrum, you know what I'm talking about. The gospel writer Mark tells us of one such incident in Jesus' life when the highest religious leaders of his time were convinced that Jesus was possessed by an evil spirit. They couldn't comprehend any other explanation for his ability to cast out demons and spirits from other people. They couldn't imagine any other reason he was able to heal people of incurable diseases. They weren't certain that Jesus's powers were anything but from the devil himself. To open their minds to even entertain the possibility that he could be doing this because of God was unthinkable, because it would mean for them to rethink everything that they believed about God. And so they accused Jesus of being possessed by an evil spirit. Even Jesus' own family tried to convince him to lay low for a while, to stop rocking the boat so much. They were aware that while he was doing so much good, he was also really stirring up a lot of people who were starting to think about killing him, religious authorities, and even the Roman government. He was attracting too much attention. He was more popular than even the governor at that time, and so you can't blame his family for wanting to keep him safe. But Jesus didn't come into this world to play it safe. He came to save people. He came to set people free. He came to do the will of God. Yes, Jesus was possessed, but not by an evil spirit, but by the Holy Spirit. He was influenced and controlled and consumed by doing the will of God, and he wasn't about to stop, because God's mission of love and salvation for the world was so important. We, as Jesus' disciples today, are to carry on that same mission from God that Jesus started. Jesus commanded his disciples, those first ones and us today, to do the will of God, and he showed us how to do that. We are to love one another, as we just heard sung by the children. We are to love one another as he loved us, and that means caring for all people, including the poor and the marginalized, the oppressed, those who society wants to cast aside. These are the people that Jesus focused on and the people we are called to focus on. We have to be possessed by the Holy Spirit like Jesus was, meaning we have to have the same consuming commitment to do God's will. We can't back down either. We can't close our eyes to the problems that are around us. We need to be the light of Christ in the world, a world that right now is very much divided. Jesus said if a house is divided against itself, that house will not be able to stand. We, like Jesus, don't make decisions based on fear, but out of genuine divine love. This is the mission that Jesus was on and that we are charged with continuing today. Let's face it, we don't want to be possessed by anything or anyone. We don't want someone controlling us. We want to be in charge. But as followers of Christ, we are to allow the Holy Spirit to control us. We are to surrender to being possessed by God's Spirit, who will work through us to accomplish God's plans. Unlike being possessed or controlled by forces that may cause harm, the Holy Spirit will always guide us to heal and restore. The Holy Spirit will always unite us instead of tearing us apart. The Holy Spirit will always lead to life. There are many examples of people being controlled and led by the Holy Spirit to be life-giving agents of God. The church is called to be the primary example of this. Each of us working together, united in Christ's love, to heal and restore and literally change the world. God can do that through the church. Yet it won't always be easy. There will be many, like those in Jesus' time, who will try and stop us. Maybe even our own families, like Jesus experienced. But we can't let that hold us back. At times, it may be so hard that we want to give up doing what is right. Yet every day, there are others in our world who are giving up because they have lost hope. So many have become cynical, believing that it's too late for them or too late for their situation to turn around. Even many Christians have become cynical and fail to really believe that God can and will ultimately turn things around. We can't be complacent anymore. We can't be any more complacent. Jesus taught us differently. We must be possessed, consumed by doing the will of God as He was. And we know that our actions are God's will if they are controlled by divine love, kindness, compassion, mercy, justice, grace, and peace. St. Paul tells us in his letter to the 2 Corinthians, we do not lose heart. Even though our outer nature is wasting away, our inner nature is being renewed day by day. It is the Holy Spirit who is renewing our inner nature by the all-consuming love of God. Our inner nature is being renewed day by day by the power of the Holy Spirit. Jesus didn't let anything or anyone stop him from doing God's will, even when it was about to cost him his life. We can't let anything stop us from doing God's will. So let us surrender to being controlled and being possessed by God's Holy Spirit and be prepared to see what amazing things that God will do through us and through this church. Amen. Our reflection hymn this morning is hymn number 400, When We Are Living.
Thank you.
Please join me in affirming our faith from a brief statement of faith found in your bulletin. We trust in God, the Holy Spirit, everywhere, the giver and renewer of life. In a broken and fearful world, the Spirit gives us courage to pray without ceasing, to witness among all peoples to Christ as Lord and Savior, to unmask idolatries in church and culture, to hear the voices of people long silenced, and to work with others for justice, freedom, and peace. In gratitude to God, empowered by the Spirit, we strive to serve Christ in our daily tasks and to live holy and joyful lives, even as we watch for God's own heaven and new earth, praying, "Come, Lord Jesus." Please be seated. We believe in a God who provides abundantly for our needs. In gratitude, let us share a portion of what we have been given for the work of this community and the benefit of our neighbors. Let us pray. O God, with faith and hope, we offer these gifts. Use them even as you use us to ease the burdens of others and to spread your message of grace and truth for all. Amen. Please be seated. In response to God's generous grace, we take time now to share our joys and our thanks. Birthdays this week include Stephen Flanders, Doug Yates, Brenda McMonigal, and Katrina Kolbschel. So happy birthday to all of you. Also, another wonderful joy that we have is thank you to all of you who supported Relay for Life that took place yesterday. The rain held out. It was a wonderful day. And our team, Rainbows of Faith and Hope, once again was the top winner. We achieved, unbelievably, thanks to your support, yet another level, the Emerald level. So far, our team has raised over $26,579,000 just from our team. So thank you. And overall, the overall Central New York Relay for Life is at over $226 $10,000. Thank you so much for your support in helping to find a cure for this terrible disease. Your generosity is making a huge, huge difference. So thank you to all of you. Again, thank you. And I would like to raise up yet another joy again, our youth today, Youth Music Sunday. The talents are just unbelievable. So please give another round of applause for them sharing their gifts today. Thank you. And now we come before the Triune God to pray for our communities, ourselves, and our world in need. Let us pray. Great and holy God, in you is more love than we can imagine, and more grace than we can fathom. You have shown yourself in Jesus Christ as a God who meets us where we are and loves us. We are glad for this day and grateful for your many gifts, including the gift of music and the young musicians in our congregation. Enliven the creativity and persistence of all seeking to transform the church into a closer vision of your beloved community. Lead our congregation in our life together and for our efforts to follow in the way of Jesus. Almighty Creator, your presence is revealed in the shade of trees, the growth of seeds into flowers, and in the blessing of plants granting food in their right season. Heal lands scarred by deforestation, pollution, or infestation. Teach us to cultivate the earth with respect and reverence for generations to come. Our nations and communities are divided, O God. Teach us again to listen with curiosity and mercy, even in disagreement. Grant us the humility to acknowledge our hardness of heart and make us bold in modeling cooperation for the sake of the common good. We pray for all the congregations in our presbytery, especially today for Forest Presbyterian Church in Lyons Falls. Lead your church into unity focused on serving you. Hear the prayers of all who cry out to you from the depths of fear, despair, or hopelessness, especially all those in war-torn countries. Touch the hearts and souls of leaders in all nations to seek peaceful solutions to problems instead of violence and war. Guide us into the ways of your wisdom. Healing God, we pray for all those who are sick in body, mind, or spirit, especially all of those listed on our prayer list, for Bonnie Herder, for all of our homebound, and for those in the military. Restore all to wholeness and guide them in their lives. We praise you, O God, for our ancestors in faith who believed and spoke and lived in you. Give us confidence that as Jesus was raised, so we too will be raised with all the saints into your everlasting presence. We offer these and all our prayers to you, Holy One, trusting that you hear and respond. And now gathered together by your Holy Spirit, we pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Our sending hymn this morning is hymn number 432, Song of Hope, and we will sing that through two times.
Thank you.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the companionship of the Holy Spirit be with us all and abide with us this day and forevermore. Amen. Let us not lose heart in doing what is right and kind and good. Because as St. Paul tells us in 1 Corinthians, even though our outer nature is wasting away, our inner nature is being renewed day by day. Renewed by God's Holy Spirit, let us be filled with gratitude and joy in all that we say and do, so that all may know that God is good all the time.